Hey everyone, Mithrandiel here with the Geekly Grind, and today we're going to be diving into Beadle and Grimm's Descent into Avernus Platinum Edition. This thing is massive and very heavy, about 12 pounds, and this is the latest Platinum Edition that they've done since they released the Waterdeep Platinum set. So we're going to dive into this, check out the big box, check out what's in that wonderful map tube there, and what the heck the infernal machine is. Let's dive right in. All right, so first we're gonna pop this guy open. It's got this kind of like leather strap on the side. It's like barely contained here. So we'll just kind of pull this guy open, and there's a bit of heft to it, and you realize when you open it, it's because on the inside of the door, there's this prop, this soul coin, essentially. And yes, it does have quite a bit of weight to it. This is actually an item that players can use in the campaign to do things like extract health from enemies and have temporary hit points and all kinds of fun stuff. And actually, the properties for this are on the back of one of the dungeon screens, which we'll take a look at in a minute here. So that's kind of nestled in here, has its own little home, but we'll set that aside for now. First thing I noticed was this little stumpy here. It's like a pit fiend, I think. I could be wrong, so I apologize, internet, if I'm wrong on this. But this guy is kind of a cute little companion you can have with you on your adventures, and so he can kind of fly along there. Now, if you have gotten the Platinum sets before, you know that Beadle and Grimm are very keen on including high quality props in these sets. And so these are a handful of essentially metal badges and icons, essentially, for the different factions that you might be working for. So those are in here as well. Now you might be wondering to yourself, like, hey, Mithrandiel, how did you get your hands on this awesome set? Did you go out and buy it? Actually, we work with the guy that designed this mini, which is super cool. His name is Chris Daly, did the logo design for this set and has done other work with Beadle and Grimm before. So speaking of which, this is a couple of minis in here. Next item kind of on the agenda. So we got both the Beadle and Grimm minis included as well. This is a really interesting inclusion. So this is a terrain toolkit, and we'll get into the maps here in a minute, but basically what this is that inside there are vinyl stickers that you can attach to the map, attach and reattach over and over again to kind of make different areas, different designs. So there's like skeletons and different pits and all kinds of cool stuff that you can include in your dungeon, like a little ritual sacrifice space and that sort of thing. So lots of really cool detailed elements you can put on the maps and then reuse them over and over again, which is awesome. Little insert here, get this guy out. All right, now we're on to the proper stuff in here. So this is, these are a number of various characters. And so the way that this works, if you haven't used it before, is that this actually hangs over the dungeon screen. And so on the front side, the players will see the character or whatever. And on the back side, for us DMs who always know what's going on, of course, obviously, it has their description and then also their stats. If, you know, whether they're good or evil, gives them some stats in case they're caught up in a tussle or whatever it is. So this is really cool because it helps keep your players engaged. Like, oh, okay, cool. This is the demon that we're talking to, or this is who we're engaged with here. And then for the DM, of course, you have those resources on the back. And it's really handy to have that kind of like hanging over the DM screen, which is awesome. Another prop here. I'm going to get to this in a second. This is something else. I'll get to that soon. Another handful of props here, including a tome, essentially, of the comprehensive thesis on the nature of the infernal. And so this kind of has information on the, you know, the blood war, the various the nine hells and the various demons and such who are in charge there, going across the river Styx and that sort of thing. Again, really, really great attention to detail, really good production quality on these items, which is, you know, obviously why you invest in something like this. So, there's also a handful of character sheets and things of that nature in here. This is pretty fun. There's an insert, a resource for red cap taunts. So there's a certain point where, you know, players are journeying through, and there's a number of disrespectful red cap guards. And included on this sheet are a number of insults that you can hurl at your players in the event that they're trying to, you know, get across or get through the gate. You know, like, prove you aren't a demon, tell me a joke, and terrible joke, clearly a demon. You know, so they're not trusting of anyone coming through, and so it gives you a little bit of a reference there, too.
What a strange person.
Now look here, my good man.
I don't want to talk to you no more, you empty-headed animal food trough whopper. I fart in your general direction. Your mother was a hamster, and your father smelt of elderberry.
So some pretty fun stuff. Got some cool images and art to include as well. And just generally another good grip here of resources that DMs and players can use in their games. This is kind of the core of it. So this is the various chapters of the game, kind of broken up into these small modular booklets. And so, again, if you're a DM and you, maybe you're new to this, or maybe you just like to be able to, you know, dive into the game and not necessarily have to worry about constructing the world and going through all that other stuff, these booklets are great because they give you the world, the environment, the various characters that they'll encounter, and then this combined with your little character cards that I was showing before means that you can kind of set up that world and get everything going, and then walk them through those various encounters. So this is basically the Descent into Avernus book, but broken up into the various chapters, so it's a little bit more manageable. You don't need to bring the whole book with you. You can just bring the relevant mini guide along instead. And then inside we have our DM screens. So gonna unfold these so we can get a different shot, and you can really appreciate what they look like. And this first one is for Baldur's Gate. So when the players are in Baldur's Gate, this is the screen that they would see. And on the back side is, you know, relevant information for the DM on the city, the maps, etc. So that you can, you know, access it when they're like, oh, so where is the, you know, where are we at? Where's the East Way? Where's, like, all these other things? You have that available. So this is more specific to what's going on in this portion of the campaign instead of your standard kind of standard DM guide, which has, like, no, if you're paralyzed, you're, you know, poisoned, etc. And then this is the DM guide for when they go to hell. So welcome to hell. And I like what it says here on the bottom. When it comes to the souls of mortals, the nine hells is always open for business. So they're always down to be capturing souls for people. And so, of course, on the inside of here, you've got information that's relevant to the nine hells. And again, as I mentioned, there's information here on the soul coin. So this kind of tells you what they can do with it, the charges, etc. And then random roll tables for what's going on in hell as well. So those are the DM screens. And that's pretty much the core of what's included when it comes to running the game and stuff like that. Now, there was one more thing that I wanted to show you. So as I mentioned, there are a number of props that are included in the set, but this was probably the coolest thing. So this is an infernal contract. So this essentially is, an agreement that a demon can give you, or rather your DM can give you as part of the game. And holy moly, this thing is super cool. So just the weight, you're hearing kind of the clanging. It's got that weight to it.
And it definitely feels like you just, you know, agreed or signed into something that you shouldn't have. So it's just, it's beautifully made. It's got this great, you know, great weight to it, really good build. And this is probably one of the coolest props I've seen for a D&D game in quite some time. So I was really stoked about this. Okay, cool. Let's dive in. Gosh, I feel like it's Christmas morning. There's stuff everywhere. Let's dive into the maps. We'll move on to that next. All right, so we have got our maps laid out here. So there's a handful here. There's a good amount of, I didn't actually count them, so I think it's close to 6 maps or something like that. So starting with Baldur's Gate. So we have a larger sized Baldur's Gate map here, kind of, you know, on a nice vinyl kind of material. And again, this kind of gives you a better idea of how the city is laid out. You know, you can, when you give the map to your players, you know, you can give them this great reference that they can utilize to kind of get the lay of the land, if they're not in hell, that is. And so we have this really great map of Baldur's Gate to kind of kick things off. And then a map that looks very different. we've got Avernus here. So we got this infernal plain laid out, you know, this kind of like lava, almost blood looking river down the middle here. Lots of great, you know, details on the various monsters, and of course a Sauron eye looking type item here. I'm sure this is like some sort of acid rain, all sorts of nastiness and not fun things, a giant skull up here. So we've got ourselves our layout of Avernus. So that's next. We've got some battle map. Well, this isn't quite the battle map. This is more of just like a small town or a hamlet, basically, you know, with a statue laid out here and everything. It obviously could be utilized if you wanted to use it for combat or something like that. It just doesn't have the battle lines built into it or anything like that. You just have to kind of approximate, or you could lay down, sometimes there's transparent ones that have the battle lines built in if you wanted to make it work like that, but do a little beyond theater of the mind there. So so that's that one. Now here we've got some internal maps. So we've got, this is actually of the elf song, upper level here and ground level. And so, you know, we have some various tables and bar tops and things like that. Some rooms and places where your heroes can rest and relax, or more likely be battling off demons and monsters, etc. Or just thugs and robbers. Now these are double-sided. So there's more happening on the backside. And that is true for the rest of the maps that I have to show you. So these guys have lots of utility, lots of value on those maps. So next we've got another kind of, it's like a ruined temple kind of area. So you got some stairs going downward into who knows what, some crumbled ruins and details here. Again, this is a nice, you know, it's a bit more than your standard people. It's not quite the vinyl feel that the Baldur's Gate map has, but it's still definitely going to be of a higher print quality than your usual, you know, just pulling it off the printer, obviously. And again, got some great details here, some murky water. Oh, cool, that's some creepy spirits there in the water on the backside. And then we've got another battle map here, a little bit more infernal in scope and design, a bit more, you know, like shattered bones and some more of that rusty tint to it that makes you feel like you are actually, you know, descending into hell, which is good when you're running through Avernus. And then on the backside, you got even more of that feel to it. So good stuff there. And then we've got the Hell Wasp Nest. So we've got, and this is one of those areas. And again, like you can utilize those stickers to really add some extra elements to it. And it's kind of faint, but you can see the markings here. So this does denote a square for 5 feet of movement. So it can be a little bit hard to pick out at a distance, but you've got that denotion there to use it in combat and things like that. So you've got that. The bone brambles as well. This is kind of like a labyrinthine, I'm gonna like preview of what's next there. You know, a labyrinthine area you know, like not being able to move through the brambles, kind of having to control, go to the middle here and that sort of thing. So this is a fun area you can take your players through. Well, fun, of course, is always subjective, right? Fun for the DM, maybe not so fun for the players, but hopefully it's fun. I hope it's fun. And then finally, we've got El Terrell, the grand city in Avernus here. And yeah, so this kind of gives you just a layout of the city and the various, you know, major, you know, notable icons and things like that in the city too. So yeah, lots of great maps included, lots of opportunities for you to run through various encounters and campaigns. One thing I didn't mention in opening the bigger box is inside of the area that had like the character sheets and the insults with the from the red caps, there are small kind of like 8.5 by 11 maps, like room maps, which is also pretty cool. So if you have a quick encounter like, oh, you go into this church or you go into this room area and you have an encounter, there's some more resources there for you as well. Cool. So we're just about there. Last thing we're going to look at is the Infernal Machine. So let's take a look. All right. So this is the Infernal Machine. Came out of that box. It says so on the box. Infernal Machine. No assembly necessary, I guess. And the hells, they make it easy for you. So we've got this excellent kind of, it's not quite a, I mean, I guess it's just a huge mini more than anything else. And this is essentially a vehicle that can be used during the campaign. So let me get this out of the way. So the Infernal Machine kind of breaks down into a couple different parts here. So the front can come off. And you can put minis in here if they like to ride in the front seat. But more notably, this part comes up. And so this is kind of the general riding area. And so you can have minis in here of your adventurers as they, you know, hop inside and say, okay, off we go, and take off across Avernus. So really, you know, honestly, this thing is, I love the devil contract, but this thing definitely has a ton of detail to it. I mean, you've got like all kinds of, you know, burnt metal details on here, you know, sharp, sharp edges on the various hooks and rough metal on the edges. So this definitely looks like something more like out of Mad Max, right? But definitely fitting in traversing the, and look at that spinning blade on the front, you know, get out of my way. So definitely a great prop and kind of the capstone. The running theme for these Beadle and Grimm Platinum sets is, first of all, you know, you'll look up the price and you'll probably be like, no freaking way. but know what you're getting, right? This is what you're getting. You are getting some really great quality props. You're getting all these amazing maps. You're getting the game built in a way that you can create this world and engage your players. And it really is just sort of like out of the box. And so, you know, friends who have invested in these sets definitely get a lot of play and use out of them. And I couldn't recommend it more highly to folks, especially for DMs who really like delivering that next level experience, like having those various props, having these maps available, and being able to say, okay, guys, hop in. That's pretty cool. And so again, Beadle and Grimm make these amazing Platinum Edition sets. Keep your eye out for it. It is available now, and I can't wait to see what they do next. So thanks so much for watching our unboxing. Again, my name is Mithrandiel. I'm the editor-in-chief for the Geekly Grind. We do all kinds of geek culture content, anime, comics, things of that nature, board games, and of course, D&D content, including weekly reviews of Critical Role. So feel free to come back and see us, and thanks again for watching.